Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to today's Sunday school lesson. I am Teacher George, and I'm going to be taking you through the lesson for today. But before we begin, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we bless you, and we honor you for this morning that you've given us to be able to learn your word, to be able to grow, and so that we can become obedient children who love you and serve you. We thank you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray and believe and say it. Amen. Now, boys and girls, we want to begin a new series when we talk about the journey of the Israelites and how God led them from a place called Egypt into Canaan. And the story today begins us off with a man called Moses. Now, Moses was an Israelite, but he was picked up when he was a small boy by one of the Egyptians' ruler, the daughter who was called the daughter of Pharaoh. And Moses was picked up from the river and taken to the palace. So Moses grew up in a palace, a big house. And he grew up until a time when he became mature and old enough. And he realized that he was not an Egyptian, but he was an Israelite. So what happened is that Moses looked at his people who were the Israelites. They were suffering in a place where they were made slaves. They were punished. And God said, I am going to deliver these people. And Moses thought to himself, I am going to help out in this thing, in helping my people. But he himself lived in the palace like the Egyptians. And so he always looked out and had mercy when he saw the Israelites suffering. So our story today comes from Exodus chapter 1 and also chapter 2, where we learn about Moses when he's young and he's walking around one day, and he's walking and he sees two Egyptians, one Egyptian fighting and beating an Israelite. And Moses became so angry. And you know what he did, boys and girls? He hit the Egyptian and he collapsed and died. And because he didn't want anyone to see, he hid the Egyptian and thought, no one has seen what I have done. Because of his anger, he was impatient and he hit him. But do you know what? Someone had seen what he had done. And that someone one day reported him, because Moses again saw two Israelites fighting and he sent them and went there and started separating them. And one of the Israelites was one who had seen him, and he says, you know what? You want to kill us like the way you killed that Egyptian and hid him? And so Moses was shocked. Someone has seen what I did out of anger. What will I do? And because he was afraid, he ran off. He ran off and went to a place called Midian to hide from the Pharaoh, because now his secret had been found out. And he disappeared from Egypt. But God was with him. And as we will be seeing in our next lesson next Sunday, we will see that God was with him. But what do we learn, boys and girls? Even when we are angry, even when we are impatient, we should always watch what we do and watch what we say. Because if Moses was not angry and impatient, he would not have done that one thing. And when we do something out of anger, it results in us doing something that is very sinful unto God. And we might think that no one is seeing, but God will see that secret. And so let us remember to always be patient, because God will fight our battles. And God, as we will see, delivered the Israelites from Egypt to Canaan. And so watch out for next Sunday as we continue with this amazing journey of learning about God being patient and God being kind as he delivers the Israelites to Canaan. Well, thank you. Now it's time for our memory verse. Comes from Psalm 37 verse 1. Psalm 37 verse 1. And it says, Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. So this memory verse teaches us to be patient and to wait upon God. So do not be in a hurry. Maybe you want something very quickly. God is saying, be patient and wait upon the Lord. And as we continue with our series about Exodus and the journey, we are going to march on in the light of God. So let's stand up even as we sing the song. We are marching in the light of God. 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 We are marching, marching, we are marching. Oh, we are marching in the light of God. We are marching in the light of God. We are marching in the light of God. We are marching, marching, we are marching. Oh, we are marching in the light of God. Let us finish with a word of prayer. Indeed, Lord, we are grateful because you'll watch over us. And I pray that you'll keep us safe even as we continue to wait upon you. Continue providing for our parents and protecting them, Lord. Help us to be patient and to be kind to others. In Jesus' name we pray and believe and say it. Amen. God bless you until next Sunday as we continue to march in the light of God. Bye-bye.